Probably you're watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you trying to open a program you have recently installed. This error arrived. The program can start because etdx9_40.dll is missing from your computer. It's a very common issue and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So start the countdown. At first, open your favorite browser and search for dtdx9_40.dll. You can choose any result you want. I'm choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see a few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your PC architecture and version, click on Start and search for System Information. Here you can see mine version and I'm a 64-bit user, so I'll be downloading the first one. I strongly recommend you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. You can try that too. As the download complete, hit Open. The downloaded GIF has two files, one is the DLL and other one is README. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. And click on the downloaded GIF, drag the DLL, and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace and click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check by typing the entire file name. You can see the file is placed in the 32-bit folder, so job is done for 32-bit users. You can go and restart your computer. Only if you are a 64-bit user like me, open this PC one more time. New volume C, Windows, and this time find a folder named syswow64. This is the home of 64-bit DLLs, and similarly drag and drop. So in a nutshell, 64-bit users need to paste the file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder too. Check this one more time. Similarly, by typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in the 64-bit folder too. So, job is done. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install Microsoft DirectX from Microsoft official website and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.